Introduction to Solar Home Systems. In this session, we're going to be talk about what do you mean by the solar home system. So basically, the solar home system is a small type of a home system, and which we are generating the solar power or electricity from the solar energy over here. Some cases, such kind of a solar home systems comes under the category of the on-grid type of the solar power plant, or comes under the category of the off-grid kind of the solar power plant. But generally, most of the cases, the off-grid kind of a system, wherever the grid supply is not been available at a particular system, so that time we are saying it is a off-grid kind of the solar home system. Generally, to fulfill the need of the home appliances or the home consumer in the residential sector, for the smaller sector actually, we are using the solar home system on that particular purpose. So basically, whenever we talk regarding the solar home system, are basically the standalone photovoltaic system that offers a cost-effective mode of supplying amenity power for lighting and appliances to the remote off-grid households. So basically, whenever we talk about the off-grid kind of a solar system, and that to be of a very smaller capacity, whenever we use the solar system for a remote area over here, so such kind of a system comes under the off-grid kind of the solar home systems over here actually. So whenever we just see this particular diagram actually, the power from the solar array or the solar panel generated in the DC format, this power has been fed to the charge controller. So basically the charge controller is the variable DC to DC converter has been fitted over here. Some cases if it is a PWM technology or NPPT technology, algorithm is also been fitted in the charge controller over here. The role of a charge controller is to extract the maximum amount of the voltage and maximum amount of the current to given panels over here actually. And it supplies or controls the voltage and the current which is going inside the battery over here actually. So that is why whenever our battery is full, it cuts the supply towards the battery, and whenever the battery is at a dead condition, so that time it will going to once again supply the solar power to the corresponding battery over here. Battery stores the power in the form of a DC supply over here actually. It will have a charge stored in form of a DC over here. So whenever we are using any home appliances in the solar home system, which runs under the voltage of a single phase volt, that is a 240 volt, or a three phase volt, that is a 415 voltages over here. Generally, the solar home system comes under the 240 volt over here actually. So whatever the television, radios, computer, refrigerator are there in the AC format, they are consuming the standard voltage of the 240 volt over here actually. So for that purpose, we require to be connect the inverter in the line over here actually. So that is why one wire, that is a positive negative wire, is been given to the inverter. Inverter role is to convert the DC form of the electricity into the alternating form. So here basically the direct current has been converted into the sinusoidal waveform over here actually. Some cases if we are using the grid supply, that is a hybrid kind of a system if we are discussing in the solar home system. So that time the role of an inverter is also to synchronize what amount of the voltage, what amount of the current, what amount of the phase and the frequency which is coming from the utility supplier. But the smaller type of the off-grid kind of the home system, there is already algorithm has been fitted so that it will give the power in the single phase manner. It will give the voltage as an adjustable up to the 240 volt, and it will give the typical amount of the current as per the capacity of the solar power plant. So once it is converted into the DC power to the AC power, then we are giving connection to the main MCB of our home systems over here actually. So in that cases, we just powering the home inside the particular residential sector by the solar system over here actually. And such kind of a small systems are comes under the solar home systems over here. So basically, solar home systems actually, it is very, very, very useful in the rural areas that are not connected to the grid supply over here actually. They are still lacking in the grid supply over here. So they can go with the solar home system with a battery operated system over here. And solar home system can use to meet the household energy demand and fulfilling the basic electricity needs over here. So basically, whenever we talk about the basic electricity need, It means what smaller amount of the power we can just power through the solar home system. But whenever we want to give a larger amount of generation of the power, so that time we can go for the on-grid kind of the solar system design or the hybrid kind of a solar system design. Some cases will have a utility scale type of a solar project. Some will have the CNI type of the solar project. So basically the solar home system comes under the smaller electricity need to be given or to be fulfilled by the small residential sectors over here actually. Globally, the solar home system provides the power to hundreds and thousands of the households in the remote location where the electrification by the grid is not feasible over here. Like in hilly areas in most of the countries, still the electricity is lacking over there actually. So that time, the green power we are using to powering the home appliances over here actually. Solar home system usually operates at a rated voltage of the 12 volt DC. Because whatever the battery we are using, that is having the voltage of the 12 volt. And as per the requirement, we can go for 150 ampere hour battery or we can go for 75 ampere hour battery. So like that, it depends upon the what power we want to store over here. Simultaneously, whichever charge controller we are using, that is also having the rated voltage or system voltage of the 12 volt over here actually. If I want to develop for the bigger kind of a system to power some more kinds of the appliances over here, so that time we can go for 20 fold system voltage over here actually. So in that cases, the battery is also having the 24 volt. Charge controller is also having the 24 volt, and as per the requirement of the storage power, we can vary the ampere hour rating of the corresponding batteries. So basically in solar home system, whatever the 12 volt direct current it is giving over here actually, and provides the power for the low power DC appliances like a light, radios and the small TVs for all about the 3 to 5 hours a day actually. In some cases, if I don't want to go for the alternative form of the electricity, so that time we can avoid the inverter in the solar system. So just solar panels we are using, we are giving power to the charge controller. From that, we are storing the power into the batteries as per the requirement. And further connections we are giving to the DC fan, your DC TV, then your DC appliances over here actually. So in that cases, as per the we are avoiding the inverter over here actually, then the cost of the system is drastically reduced over here actually. So in that cases, we can go for the DC kinds of the solar system or the DC to AC kinds of the solar systems over here. So as per the requirement of the storage power, we can store the power for the 3 to 4, 5 hours over here with a battery capacity of the 75 ampere hour or 60 ampere hour or 150 ampere hour as per the requirement. Furthermore, basically when we talk, there are appliances such as the cables, switches, mounts and structural parts. These are the quite parts are there actually whenever we just design the solar home systems over here, and the power conditioner that is also called as the inverter over here whenever we are talking regarding the DC to AC conversion, which changes the 12 volt or 24 volt of the system into the 240 volt AC over here actually for powering the larger appliances over here. So it is a quite bigger kind of a solar system whenever we are powering to the larger appliances over here. So in that cases, we can develop a solar home system for 0.3 kilowatt, 0.5 kilowatt, 0.8 kilowatt, 1 kilowatt, 5 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt or 3 kilowatt. Depends upon the consumer requirement over here. How much power it required to be stored, how much power will be required for the equipments that are been available in the corresponding residential sector over here. Next thing, whenever we talk regarding why this particular solar home system, basically they contributes to the improvement of the standard of living actually. Whenever we talk about very remote areas, still the electricity is not been available. So that time such kind of a DC systems is very, very, very important in the particular case. It reducing the indoor air pollution and therefore improving the health as their replace of the kerosene lamp. So they were not going to use the kerosene lamp, they will go for the DC kinds of the solar system, which is quite cost effective system actually. So nowadays various subsidies has been available to promote the solar energy in the every country over here actually. So that time we can just go for the DC Lalten over here or DC home systems over here also to avoid the heavy cost investment in the solar system actually. It also providing the lighting for the home studies for the students also, and giving the possibility of the working at the night facility also. It also facilitating to access the information and technology like a computer, radios and TV that you are going to powered by the solar power system. So basically the solar home system is very, very, very important whenever there is a far reach of the grid supply in the corresponding country. So simultaneously we can going to learn to design how we just going to design the solar home system. It will going to power the large amount of the residential sectors over here.